Hey guys, Prince of Mastodon here. Gonna do a quick battle for Total War Warhammer. Let's hope the freaking thing works this time. For some reason, with this latest patch, it's been really hard connecting to the other person now. Like, there's been several times where it says it's found match, but I'd be stuck on that screen for like 2 or 3 minutes. Thankfully, this one actually moved. Snowpiercer. He's gonna go with the green skins. I might go with the Empire, I guess. Sure. What kind of abilities can I not? Should I not bring? I like all these abilities, to be honest. All of them. Probably gonna bring toughness because that's más importante. I don't need much in terms of cav. I'll bring two of these guys, I guess, but they're so expensive. Man, they've really weakened these demogryphs. Like, they weakened them in the previous patch, and then they weakened them even more in this patch. Anyhow, could I bring here maybe some crossbowmen? Maybe give him some ups, maybe? Let's go with that. So he's gonna use the Warriors of Chaos. We will see what kind of a build he has for him. Snowpiercer. Huh. Well, I hope we're not fighting in snow then. Anyhow, the timer is ticking since I'm ready. And he's ready now too. So let's see what kind of game he brings against me. You think we'll be seeing Archaon? What kind of commander do you guys expect this guy to bring? We'll see. Alright, here we go. Any second now. Alright. He's got a seriously small army, which leads me to believe he is spamming something. Like a special character or giants or something like that. Let's put the halberds in the front then. I'm gonna stand back a little bit. Let me put these guys in skirmish mode. Let's see what kind of spam army he has. Well, he has some of these dragon ogres. They are pretty expensive. What is this unit? It's a chaos sorcerer fire. Must have some really elite infantry here. Interesting. Let's go and hotkey my commander here. I wonder if my demogryph halberds can take on these dragon ogres. I don't know. It could be worth the risk. Like risking a duel with them. See what happens. I have to get my commander out of there. Oh, he brought Ziegfeld! No way! That's awesome. Yeah, I gotta figure out if he's gonna summon some kind of magical spell on me or something. Alright, I'm gonna start the fight on the left. I wanna see if my Demogryph can take it on. It'll be good experience. Learning experience. Here we go. We get to see who wins this fight. He wants to know too. Let's see what happens here. I think his... Well, my guys are going down too. Yeah, remember, the patch weakened my guys, so... Here comes Zigfault. I'll let Zigfault beat the crap out of my guys for a bit. I want to take out his Chaos Sorcerer. Yeah, he won. Let's activate that. Gotta take out this freaking dude over here. Let's whack him before he commits a spell. There we go, we're gonna take him out right away. Boom! Now I have to look out for this dragon ogre, because they are gonna come in charge. Oh, I took out the dragon ogres over here! How was that possible? They always take off at the last second. To avoid them. I hate that. These guys are skirmishing way too far. Yes, my lord. To war. Alright, that thing's gone. Let's go for Zigfault. These guys should be breaking over here. Crap, he's destroyed my center over here. Holy hell, he's destroyed it. Well, what's at least beat the crap out of these guys first? Alright, we gotta take on Zigfault. Anyhow, it's going to be kind of harder taking on Zigfault because of his armor, his Auric armor, which gives him regenerative things. I'm glad they gave it to him, though, the Chaos. But we're going to bring him down, though, because I know how to bring him down. I use him all the time. I'm going to target his morale real quick with Bloody Roar. Look at Zigfault going down. He is going down hardcore, and all my guys are coming back. That's great. I'm gonna take my potion here in a second. Now let's go for Zigfault. After holding my line. Get him! Get Zigfault! Whoomp! Whoomp, there it is. Yeah, this guy's toast. Man, dude. Come on, Siegfault. I feel so sad attacking him, though. He's gonna bite it, though. And when he does, his men are gonna crumble. Those guys back there are standing around. His chosen. Oh, Siegfault is not gonna hack it like this. Oh, this battle's over. Oh, that should hurt him a lot. Yeah, his guys are shattering. Come on, kill him! Holy cow, this takes forever. I want to actually destroy him, kill him, slaughter him. There we go, that should take him. Now he's shattered. Alright. Alright, good game to my opponent. Yeah, those are like so many chosen units. I like that he brought Siegfault though, that's awesome. Let's see if that fixed my ranking a little bit. Nah, a little bit. I'm trying to see if I knew Snowpiercer. I've seen that name before. There he is. He was ranked, I don't know where he was ranked, but now he's numbered 124.
Hey guys, Prince of Mastodon here, of course, and I'm going to show you the replay aspect of this battle that I had against Snowpiercer. And again, Snowpiercer was probably in the top, maybe 120s when I played against him. He dropped to like 124 or 125 after we fought. And I went up 3 points myself, so that was good. Anyways, look at his army. It looks, I don't want to take credit for it, but it looks really inspired by my builds. You know, I'll take some infantry belt, then I'll take 2 giant monsters. In his case, he brought dragon ogres. I usually bring chaos giants. And he also brought a sorcerer to help out with the magic, to supplement the lack of magic that Siegfault uses, or the lack of magic that Siegfault doesn't have. But my build, I brought 2 crossbows to give me some range. I brought 2 demogryphs, 4 greatswords, 4 halberds, and a captain. And once this battle starts, going to turn off the user interface so we can just focus on the sweet close-ups. However, I'm still very sad that I had to fight against Siegfault. It's very sad indeed. Alright, so, this is me. This is my general of the Empire. And here are my crossbows. These guys are pretty sweet. I just don't take them that often. Like, I feel like when I do take missile units, they're usually handgunners. But I wanted to show some love for the crossbows, but I think they're pretty important for your troops sometimes. For your armies, I mean. My halberdiers, of course, and my greatswords. And then, obviously, I put my demogryph halberds on both wings here. Just want to keep an eye out on the this army of Snowpiercer. And yeah, we are fighting in the snow, so that's perfect. So this is what the dragon ogre looks like. They're pretty damn epic looking, actually. But as I said, In place of his dragon ogres, I usually bring the chaos giants. But I have tinkered with dragon ogres as well in my builds for chaos. But again, I am the Empire. I'm not these guys. This is my opponent, Snowpiercer's army. This guy does have shields. He's probably expecting me to bring a lot of missiles. I only brought two. And look at Zigfald! Being a freaking glorious bastard there. I am really sad though, he's usually in my armies, not my opponent's armies. But yeah, he put Dragon Ogres on both wings. Now, I do open up this fight with a charge on his Dragon Ogres. I wanted to see if my Demogryph could take him. And obviously in the 101, or in the live commentary, you saw that my guys were not successful on this side, but they were successful on the other side. Let's go see what Zigfald's doing over here. He's being a freaking badass. He's acting as a meat shield for his own army. This is the Lord himself, using himself as a meat shield. Maybe he just wanted to show off his gym body here for my troops. He just jumps in there and just cuts my heads off. It's pretty epic. But yeah, if I don't do anything about Zigfald here, then it's going to be really hard. Because Zigfald with the auric armor, he does have that regenerative ability. So you can't ignore him too long anymore. And that's good, because before he was pretty useless. But now you can't ignore him anymore. And this guy, I don't know what the hell that is. But I landed my general back over here. And it's gonna be on this side where I'm a lot more successful. Oh, this is why I won on the right. It's because I had a slight incline on the hill here. Whereas on the other side where I engaged his Dragon Ogres with my Demogryphs, it was flat terrain. So I think on even terrain, the Dragon Ogres will definitely beat my Demogryphs. But the Dragon Ogres are pretty expensive. That said, I do manage to beat him here because of the terrain advantage on that side. Enemy wizard. So let's go look at Zigfald's latest escapades on this fight. His latest icecapades. If I can find him. Oh, here he is. He's one-on-one-ing with my commander. No, sorry. That's his sorcerer. Zigfald's still fighting in the thick of my troops, but yeah, this is me going right for his sorcerer. I wanted to prevent him from launching those spells on my infantry. Where is Zigfald? You'd think a blonde would stick out in this fight. I don't see him though. Do you see him? Holy cow. Anyways, if you follow my commander, we'll find Zigfald, because I do target Zigfald eventually with my commander. This is like finding Waldo. I can't find Zigfald. Well, that's fun. Anyways, Demogryff charged from behind. Hammer and anvil in the style of Alexander the Great. Still trying to find the enemy commander here on the replay. Anyways, this is when my opponent just shattered my left flank, see this? He just overran it completely. There he is, there's Zigfald. How could I not find him? That was weird. So I'm curious, if anyone has the inside scoop on this. There is still quite a lot of blood on Zigfald's armor here, it looks like. I thought the patch got rid of the blood on his armor. I mean, see for yourself. Well, there you see. There's blood on his armor, on his face, on his shield. See that? I thought the patch did away with that. Or maybe I'm blind. Because I was really looking forward to showing Zigfald without blood. But no, blood is on his hands. Look at this greatsword just chilling back here. Where do you think he's going? Looks almost like Brunner. Brunner the Bounty Hunter. Anyhow, let's go and focus on this fight with Zigfald. Zigfald's pretty tough, but up against my flying mounts, he doesn't really stand a chance if I just keep up the attacks on him. But on the other hand, that means I'm neglecting the rest of my troops on the other parts of the battlefield, so it's a trade-off. I can keep hunting for Zigfald, but in doing so, I'm neglecting the rest of my troops. Oh, here come the dragon ogres. Oh man, they smashed my greatswords up right back there. That was awesome. Alright. So, sweet action so far. Alright, so I've asked you about your favorite races, favorite factions in this game, but who are your favorite characters in the Warhammer Fantasy lore? Favorite characters, guys? Think of it. Mine's obviously going to be Prince Siegfried the Magnificent. But there's some other ones out there. Like, as I mentioned, Brunner the Bounty Hunter. He's a pretty cool character. And I don't think he really... He does appear in End Times, but he doesn't... He doesn't have a character in this game. That'd be awesome if he was. Like, if he showed up as a special character. Anyhow, look at my dude coming here, chasing these guys down. But also, Wolfric the Wanderer, freaking amazing character. Wolfric is a Warriors of Chaos champion. He just wanders the world, picking fights with people. He basically got cursed by the gods after one night where he boasted that he was the best warrior in the world, cannot be beaten by anybody, not even the gods. So the Chaos Gods decided to curse him. They forced him to wander the earth, picking fights with people. And they did give him the ability to speak other tongues. That way, whenever he made challenges, people would understand it. And yeah, he was not content to sit around after the curse. He only felt happy when he was wandering the world, picking fights with really monstrous beings. But yeah, definitely my favorite is going to be Siegfried Magnificent. But yeah, who's your favorite character in the Warhammer Fantasy lore? And obviously, they don't have to be in this game, because the game still does not have even a fraction, not a significant fraction, of the characters that are actually mentioned in the books. Anyways, guys, good game to my opponent, and I hope you enjoyed this replay.